Listen, I'm going to teach you something quickly, okay? This is the structure to say, I don't understand what he said. So what do you say this in Mandarin? I don't understand what he said. So the whole sentence would be, 他说的话我不懂。他说的话我不懂。 All right. So before you jump into the sentence structure, you should be able to understand the vocabulary in the sentence. First of all, you should know what is 说话. All right. So let me code it for you. 说话. So what is 说话? 说话 means to speak. This is a verb-object-verb. What is a verb-object-verb? 说 means to say. 话 means spoken language. So to say a spoken language means to talk, okay, or to say something. So 说话, this is a very weird concept. We call verb, object, verb. To talk, spoken language means to talk. All right, 说话. 他说的话. So here you see the de here. Usually, we would say anything before the, you see, combined together is modifying the noun here. So the language he says, okay, I'll say that again, 话 is the spoken words, the things that he said, 他说的话, okay, the things that he said, 我不懂. Here's the complement. What is complement? So it's just talk about the things. What things? The things that he said. Okay? The things that he said, I don't understand. 他说的话我不懂. Alright? So 说话. When you are forming a sentence, you have to think about what is my verb object? What is my verb object? What is the VO? Okay, so 说话 is my verb object. So the things that he said, I don't understand. Remember, you have to put the here. Okay, the here represent that everything before here, everything before the is modifying the 话. Okay, the word 话 here. Now let's take a look at some few sentences. Okay, just take a look at two sentences here. 他说的英文我都不懂. The, do you see? The. So, 他说的英文. So, where's the verb object? 说英文. Okay? Speak English. 说英文. 说英文. Speak English. So, the English that he speaks, complement here, 我都不懂. So, 我都不懂, I all not understand. I don't understand at all. I all not understand. I don't understand at all. So, I don't understand at all the English that he says. So, when you're doing the translation or the structure of Mandarin, it's actually totally different from English or totally different from maybe European languages. And it's the opposite, the other way around to translate it. Okay, so 我都不懂, I don't understand. I don't understand what? The English. What English? The English that he says. So 他说的英文我都不懂. Let's take a look at the next sentence. 你姐姐穿的衣服很时髦. 时髦是 fashionable. So what is the verb object? If you are sensitive enough, you know the verb object is just right next to the, right? So, 穿衣服, 穿衣服 is the verb object, wear clothes, 穿衣服, because they are next to the, so you know 穿衣服 is their verb object. So, the clothes, very fashionable. 衣服很时髦. 衣服很时髦. Clothes, very fashionable. But what clothes? So these things right here, just modifying the clothes. 你姐姐穿的衣服. So the clothes your older sister is wearing. 你姐姐穿的衣服很时髦. Very fashionable. Okay, so I'll give you two sentences and please write down your sentence for me to translate these two sentences down below. The first sentence is, 你今天买的青菜很新鲜. Please tell me what does that mean and where is the verb object here? 你今天买的青菜很新鲜. 第二个句子, the next sentence, 陈老板卖的橘子都很甜. 陈老板卖的橘子都很甜. What does this sentence mean? And where is the verb object? Alright, that's all for today's short video lesson. And this is kind of a new method of my video lesson I can come up with without me in the screen and just pointing out with the PDF file. And please tell me what you think about this kind of video lesson. And if you like it, I will try to do it more in the future and come up with a plan and to do maybe another video series on my website. Thank you for watching as always. 谢谢你们, 再见.